60 years ago, I told stories to my three boys about a hairy beach ball that had come to Earth and could roll very fast, could bounce, and could change shapes. I do not remember what stories I told, but they seemed to enjoy them. So when I decided to write a novel in which brilliant aliens from outer space, not from outer space, from a different universe, came to this planet, it was natural for me to use that character that I told my children about. His name was Dr. Bulge, and that is how that particular shape with hair came about. I am very critical of contemporary American capitalist, consumer, militaristic society. I wanted to write a book expressing those views, but I realized that if an author criticizes his society, no one will particularly listen. Whereas if brilliant people from outer space come, take one look at the society and find it pitiful and horrible, that would have more authority, and also I could make it funnier. I certainly think seriousness is the sickness which makes human beings much less happy than they can be, much less free. Voltaire wrote a wonderful satire, Candide, in which Candide takes an idea very seriously, and no matter what happens to him, he continues to hold on to the idea, which is ridiculous. But that is the way most human beings live their lives. They have a few ideas they take very seriously, and it limits them, closes them in, makes them have fewer selves that they can express in life, and therefore they live in a rut and are not able to enjoy life as they should. Seriousness is the sickness. The freedom is fun, play, laugh. Remember, the radicals and progressives of the 1960s, when they protested, they went to the U.S. stock market and threw money out onto the stock market floor as a way of expressing the absurdity of what they thought of the capitalist system. And Abby Hoffman and Jerry Rubin and other radicals of that period were playful as well as serious. And I don't see that in the United States these days at all. I don't know about France. In the last week, I have met the French artist Gilles Barbier and his family, and we spent several hours, many hours in 2 days with his family. And Gilles himself is very playful, his art is very playful, and he is always smiling and laughing. And then I met his family. He has four children. And they do not walk along the street, they dance. And in all the time I spent with them, I don't think a single minute went by without one of them laughing, and usually many of them laughing. And it's that childish playfulness that it is so sad that adults lose. When I walk the streets of Paris or New York and look at people sitting in a cafe and watching the people go by, 9 out of 10 are very sober, serious, and don't seem to have any glow or happiness to them. Very few people have brightness in their face and happiness. And certainly I see no adults walking along the streets of New York and Paris. And that is a great loss. I have no idea of the future ever. There are so many random events taking place every second that I cannot predict anything about the future, either mine or society's. I don't have a faintest idea.
Invasion est le 10e livre de Luc Reinhardt. Luc Reinhardt, c'est un auteur qui s'est révélé sur la scène internationale en 1971 avec son premier roman qui s'appelle L'Homme D, qui en France est publié par les éditions de L'Olivier. L'Homme D, c'est cette histoire d'un psychothérapeute ou psychiatre qui décide d'abdiquer la possibilité de faire des choix moraux au profit de tout jouer avec des dés. Et en fait, c'était une première manière de découvrir l'esthétique de Reinhardt, qui est une esthétique qui mêle un très fort sens de la comédie. C'est-à-dire, dans tous ses romans, on rit beaucoup. Et en même temps, une littérature philosophique, une littérature d'idées, et une littérature qui a une dimension à la fois anarchiste et libératrice. Et ce qui est intéressant avec Invasion, qui est donc son dernier roman, c'est que d'une certaine façon, même si c'est son 10e livre, c'est celui qui est le plus près de L'Homme D. Donc si vous avez aimé L'Homme D, vous adorez Invasion. C'est ce petit dispositif, à savoir des extraterrestres arrivent et mettre le bordel dans la vie d'Américains moyens, c'est un moyen pour montrer comment une sorte de dose de folie, d'anarchie, fait exploser toutes les choses auxquelles on croit. Et on se rend compte que la plupart des choses auxquelles on croit n'ont en fait que la valeur qu'on leur donne, et non pas de vraie valeur.